Thanks to blockchain technology, we are moving toward a trustless economy, with no need for third parties to exchange goods. Centralized exchanges keep their systems off-chain, meaning transactions are not recorded on the blockchain. This leads to massive breaches of security and unsafe storage of information, funds, and private keys. In 2020, we saw the rise of decentralized exchanges, or DEXs, from Uniswap and SushiSwap on Ethereum. Decentralized exchanges or DEXs aim to overcome the problems that impede centralized structures by building peer-to-peer marketplaces directly on the blockchain. They achieve this via programming code that enables applications to self-execute agreements, otherwise known as smart contracts. The two obvious advantages of DEXs are security and sovereignty. The fact that they are decentralized means there is no one entity that can be hacked. In DEXs that utilize an automated market-making model, liquidity pools act as the counterparty for every trade. If someone is selling coins, the liquidity pool acts as the buyer. Likewise, when someone buys coins, the liquidity pool acts as the seller. DEXs serve as the backbone of economic activity conducted on blockchain networks. Today we will investigate one of them. I am Tony from KK Technologies. Let's discover the protocol that aims to incentivize a distributed network of computers to operate an exchange where users can buy and sell derivative contracts. Perpetual Protocol. Perpetual Protocol is a decentralized exchange, DEX, for futures on Ethereum and xDai. Traders can go long or short with up to 10x leverage on a growing number of cryptocurrencies. Briefly, is a decentralized perpetual contract protocol for every asset. A perpetual contract is a derivative similar to a futures contract, but without an expiry date. Perpetual Protocol uses a process that includes a virtual automated market maker, vAMM, and collateralization vault. With automated market makers, assets are deposited in liquidity pools that have two tokens as a trading pair. Liquidity providers, which are known as LPs, earn fees from that pool. These fees are obtained from users who trade against assets in the pools. The virtual automated market maker is made for price discovery and not spot exchange. With most automated market makers, a user can deposit two assets into a pool which are represented as X and Y in the well-known constant product formula, pioneered by Uniswap. XY equals K. There is no real asset pool, K, stored inside the virtual automated market maker itself. Instead, the real assets are stored in a smart contract vault that manages all of the collateral backing the virtual automated market maker. Perpetual Protocol uses a virtual automated market maker as a price discovery mechanism, instead of a direct liquidity pool for spot trading like Uniswap, Balancer, or Curve. Actually, there are no real assets, X and Y, stored inside the virtual automated market maker. That's why it's called virtual. Instead of this, the assets are sent to a smart contract that accepts deposits and records position ownership such as initial margin, level of leverage, and the direction of the position. This contract is called as clearing house. Upon receiving the funds, the clearinghouse deposits them in the vault, which manages all of the collateral backing the virtual automated market maker. Every hour, traders with open long or short positions will pay each other a funding payment, depending on market conditions. If the contract price is above the spot price, longs will pay shorts. If the contract price is below the spot price, shorts will pay longs. The size of the funding payment is a function of the difference between the contract price and the spot price, as well as your position size. This incentivizes traders to take the unpopular side of the market. To sum up, users can trade with up to 10x leverage and open long or short trading positions on various assets, such as gold, fiat, Bitcoin, and Ethereum via Perpetual Protocol. PERP token itself is used in staking, but is primarily designed to facilitate decentralized governance of the protocol. Holders of PERP tokens accrue voting rights proportional to their holdings. Cryptocurrencies are highly volatile, so your cash can go down as well as up in the blink of an eye. As always, you should never invest in something you don't understand. What are your thoughts about Perpetual Protocol? Would you use or invest in it? Let me know in the comments section below. If you find this video helpful, please tap the subscribe button.